This is our question asked in today's Skill Rack Daily Challenge. The main concept of the question is there are n rooms given and then a boy can start from any of the room using the magical key. And then now the boy can travel to the remaining rooms using the key present in the room which he opens. And if the key present in the room is same as the room from which he started, then the game ends. And our task is to find the maximum number of the rooms which he would be visiting. So let us see our sample input 1. So for this particular input, our expected output is 4. And each room has the key for the particular room. That is, the first room has the key for the 5th room. The second room has key for the 4th room. The third room has the key for 0th room. So like this, every room has the key for other rooms. So let us see how we are getting the value 4 as our output. So these are all the given values of n. First, let us assume that the boy opens the 0th room with the magical key. So when he opens this room, he has the key for 5th room. So now he can travel to this particular room. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now he has moved one room. And now in the 5th room, he has the key for 6th room. This is the 6th room. So now he has made another one travel. Now in the 6th room, he has the key for 2nd room. So 0, 1, 2. Now he can travel to this room. So plus 1. In this room, he has the key for 0th room. So now again he has made a move. But this is the room from which he started and he has reached the same room from which he started. So now the program should end. So this is the maximum number of rooms which he can visit if he starts from this particular room. Let us now assume the boy opens the first room with the magical key. In this room, he has the key for 4th room. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now he can travel to this room. So he has made one travel. And now in this room, he has key for the first room. So 0, 1. So now he has made another travel. So the boy has reached the same room from which he started. So the game ends. So the maximum number of rooms he can visit when he opened the first room with the magical key is 2. So 2 is written. So now I have found out all the remaining number of moves that the boy can do when he opens the remaining rooms with the magical key. So out of all these values, the maximum value has occurred is 4. So this is why we are printing the value 4 as the output. Now let us see how to implement a logic for this. So this is the program I have written. Initially, I have declared some variables n and I. And then in the next line, I have accepted the value of n. And in the next line, I have declared an array of size n. And then using a for loop, I'm accepting the values of n. And then I'm creating another variable named max rooms, in which we would be storing our expected result. So our task is to find the number of moves that the boy can do when he opens every room. So that we are using a for loop that iterates from 0 till n minus 1. So in every iteration, we would be calculating the maximum number of moves that the boy can do when he opens the particular room with the magical key. So inside the for loop, we are declaring 3 variables. So the first one, start room key, in which we are storing the value of I. The value of I is nothing but the room number which is opened with the magical key. And the same value is stored in temp initially. And in every iteration, the value of temp would be changing. And then we are creating another variable C and setting its value initially to 0. And in this variable C, we would be storing the number of moves that the boy would be doing when he opens the particular ith room with the magical key. Now we have declared a while loop like this. So when we declare a while loop like this, the loop would be executing until a break condition is executed. or else the loop would be working infinite number of times. So inside the loop, again we are creating a variable current room key. So our first task is to find the key present in the room which the boy opens with the magical key. And then using that key, we have to travel to the next room and find the key present in that particular room. So which we are doing in these two lines. So let us understand how these lines works with a sample example. Let us assume the boy opens the 0th room with the magical key, and the key present in the 0th room is 5. So the key present in the 0th room can be found by ARR of 0, which we are doing here. And now with the 5th room key, the boy can move to the 5th room. So when we store the value of current room key in the variable temp, we would be able to find the key present in the 5th room. So now when we store the value 5 in temp, ARR of 5 would be having the key present in the 5th room. So like this, we can be finding the maximum number of rooms that the boy can move. And in every iteration, we are incrementing the value of C. And then we are also checking whether the current room key is equal to the start room key. If it is so, as given in the question, the game ends. So we are using a break condition. So this is how this while loop works. And after the execution of while loop, the value stored in the C would be the maximum number of moves that the boy can do. And we are checking whether the value of C is greater than max rooms. So the value of max room is initially 0. And when this statement is executed for every iteration of the for loop, we would be finding the maximum value of C that has occurred, which is our required output. So after the execution of the for loop, we would be just printing the value stored in the variable max room, and that would be our required output. So let us see whether this program works or not. So now I'm going to give the sample input 1. And for the sample input 1, our expected output is 4. So we are also getting the value 4. So now let me give the sample input 2. For the sample input 2, our expected output is 7. So we are also getting the value 7. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. Thank you for watching.